There aren't that many stories that are like this one.
I think what we sometimes don't appreciate is how challenging it is to actually bring discovery in an academic setting to patients. For all of us who are physician scientists, one of the major disorders that we would see in hematology are patients with sickle cell disease.
The root cause of the disease is when there's a mutation in hemoglobin that causes red blood cells to acquire a sickle shape. We've known for decades that there's a fetal form of hemoglobin.
And it was hypothesized that if one could increase fetal hemoglobin, we would ameliorate sickle cell disease.
I was a first-year medical student, hadn't done very much, and I went to Stu with the utmost conviction, and I said, I really want to work on this problem in hemoglobin switching.
One of the key discoveries made by Vijay Sankaran and Stuart Orkin was that genetic variation in a gene called BCL11A is very important to turning on and off fetal globin.
We found if we made a single cut of the gene, the cells would make lots of fetal hemoglobin.
And I remember getting that result, and I immediately contacted Stu, and I said, oh, you gotta see this, it's incredible.
What we had to do was take that experiment that worked in a dish or in animals and make it so that it worked in people.
That was really where both CRISPR Therapeutics and Vertex Pharmaceuticals had an incredible role.
You have to figure out how to make a medicine, you have to figure out how to show it works, you have to show it's safe, you have to be able to manufacture it, then you need to do clinical trials, then you need to actually work with regulatory agencies, then you need to actually get it to patients.
I'll say along the way, there's obviously moments where, you know, you're uncertain. Are the clinical trials going to succeed?
And that was really an amazing moment when we saw the first data, and the result was pretty remarkable, and we realized that this idea had become a reality.
The results of the trial are really quite remarkable in that 95% of the patients are now clinically well.
Seeing patients benefit from this therapy has just been incredibly rewarding because it's really been transformative for those patients who've been able to have their symptoms abated.
Basic science is incredibly important. Without the understanding of what to do, you can't possibly make a medicine.
The story of Casgevy is really an example of how discovery in an academic setting and then translation of that in the for-profit setting can work exceedingly well to the benefit of patients.
We need the connection, and this story is a great example of that.
I could never have imagined that the work we were doing in the laboratory was gonna come to this, frankly. We hoped, but we didn't know.